Let's take a general look at the user interface. 3ds Max is a Windows application with a menu bar that gives you access to many commands and functions. All the menus are neatly arranged according to their functionality, such as object creation, modification, animation, rendering, and so on. And of course, the help menu is a great place to go for some extra help as you begin working in 3ds Max. Right below the menus is the main toolbar, where you can access important, often used functions like undo and redo, as well as the transformation tools move, rotate, and scale. This is also where you'll find the important windows like the material editor and the render dialog. You can access other toolbars by right-clicking an empty gray area of the main toolbar, then choosing the toolbar you want to view. Toolbars can be floating, but you can also dock them to the left, bottom, right, or top of the screen. You can also make a dock toolbar floating again by grabbing its handle and tearing it out into the viewing area. To close a toolbar, right-click either its handle or the empty gray area of the main toolbar again and disable the option. The next bar down is the modeling ribbon, which contains all the tools you'll need for polygon modeling. These tools become available when you first select an editable polygon object and enter the Modify panel on the right of the UI. You can collapse or expand the ribbon, and like the main toolbar, you can drag out the ribbon and dock it in a different location. Let's put it back in its original position for now. The right-hand side of the screen features the command panels. This is where you can access most of the program's functionality. In fact, many of the commands found in the main pull-down menus and modeling ribbon are also in the command panels for ease of access. There are 6 command panels in all: Create, Modify, Hierarchy, Motion, Display, and Utilities. Each one has its own set of important features. For now, we'll concentrate on the first two, Create and Modify. As their name implies, the Create panel is used to create geometry, and the Modify panel to change parameters and modify the shape or certain aspects of the geometry. Let's take a look at the Create panel. By default, it's set to Geometry, which are objects that have volume. There are other types of objects such as 2D splines, lights, cameras, animation helpers, and so on that can be created here. At the geometry level, you can access additional types of 3D shapes from the drop-down menu. Let's start by creating a box. You can see the parameters of this box in the Create panel first when you make it, and you can adjust them as needed here. But it's a good practice to always go to the Modify panel to make necessary changes after you've drawn out your object. Once in the Modify panel, you can change the box values in many ways. For example, click in a field and enter a value. You can also click the spinner to change the value incrementally. Or you can drag on the spinners directly for a faster change. Sometimes a command panel can become too lengthy for the screen resolution available, especially if it contains many different rollouts, which are sections of parameters. You can see an example of a lengthy panel in the Display panel. This panel includes options to hide or show objects, or to freeze objects in case you don't want to select them by mistake. In any panel, click a rollout to expand or collapse it. When the information is too lengthy, you can scroll the panel up or down, either by dragging the scroll bar or placing the cursor in a blank area where you can see the hand cursor, then dragging up or down. You can also click the panel and use the mouse wheel to scroll. To access many rollouts at the same time, you can drag the command panel to the left to give it more room. The working areas are called viewports, where you view and modify your scene in 3D space. Obviously, They're very important, and we take a look at them in a future lesson entitled Working with Viewports. On the left is the Scene Explorer, a great tool for managing scene objects as it gives you an inventory of your scene. This panel is for viewing, sorting, filtering, and selecting objects in your scene. You can also rename, delete, hide, and freeze objects, create and modify object hierarchies, and edit some object properties. To the left of the Scene Explorer panel is the Viewport Layout tab, which allows you to quickly choose among many different viewport layouts. The layouts are saved with the scene so you can return to your custom viewport setup at any time. You'll find the animation slider bar and the timeline at the bottom of your screen. This area is for object animation and includes buttons for animation modes, animation filtering, and playback controls. For a closer look, see the animation lesson using simple keyframing. The bottom left portion of the screen contains an area for Mac script users to use scripting for custom functions and automated tasks. Transform type-ins are at the bottom center of the screen. You can use these to enter X, Y, and Z values to position, orient, or scale a selected object in space. Finally, in our initial tour, the bottom right portion of the screen houses two rows of icons for viewport navigation. These are essential for properly viewing the scene, zooming, panning, and orbiting around 3D space. For more in-depth coverage of this, see the lesson, Navigating the Scene. While the UI may seem daunting at first, with practice, many things will become second nature to your workflow.